Yes. Okay.
I did it myself.
I love the front.
One thing.
You look good. You look good. You good job. Okay.
So let me knock this out.
If you and I do business later on,
yeah.
Take care of you, right?
Hey. How are you? She looks gorgeous, isn't she? I should just take the hat. Oh, yeah.
Yes. That's my first day of fighting.
Good, Mike. Let's see. Oh, yeah, you look nice.
That's pretty. You look pretty girl.
In Times Square.
Yeah. Not good. That's okay. Well,
just
no, okay. Right. That's what I said. You can see the
yeah.
Who?
Craig.
He's the director. I was going to film.
But, Sylvia.
Yeah. Their dad come by. Their dad a friend of my, you know, my family.
Thank you. sit in front of the camera and tell me that to me tempted to go sit in front of the camera.
How much is that? My mom is, Anita and my mom are best friends.
Oh, yeah.
My mom is Gloria Thomas.
Yeah.
So,
boy,
so
I'm a new one. How you doing, man? I am trying to hear.
Wow.
And see if he does it better.
Oh,
he'll be right here. You
want to get
pictures? No, I got pictures.
Thank you. take the flowers down. We take
casket spray.
Oh, we'll roll it down.
Thank you.
question. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Margaret Johnson died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Our entrance procession is just a closer walk with thee.
Daily walking close to thee. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Margaret Johnson, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated and listen to the first reading.
The first reading is from 2 Corinthians 5, verses 1, 6 through 10. Second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. So we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight, yet we are courageous. And we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should wander the valley of death,